this out, guys. He's telling me to go down. Okay, I'll go.
Uh-oh, look at this deal. Uh-oh.
How you doing, sir? Okay. Yeah, I was gonna grab a picture, but I won't. No problem. Okay. Thank you so much.
All right, he said I could take a picture, and then I gotta get off the main drag.
Love it.
Guys, I don't really know what I'm supposed to do now, you know. My plan to park out front didn't quite work, so here I am. I'm gonna drive another lap around the block. Hopefully I can find another better spot to park up and get some really good videos of this thing. This is my first time filming with my fancy gimbal here, and I'm still figuring out how to use it, so it's still kind of swinging and swaying, so I'll figure it out. But yeah, I'm gonna, like I said, drive this thing around the block again. Hopefully I can shift a little better this time, because I'm not happy with how that went first go around. I gotta figure out where to park this thing and not get in trouble, so see what I can do.
Better than I go up.
Man, figure that one out.
I'm thinking I'm gonna go around Broad Street, get back around, and try, like I said, try to find somewhere to park. I don't know.
Across. I don't know.
it's easier to go down, you know? Like I said, it's different empty too, you know, it's built to have a load on it. So I don't know if maybe, like I said, I'm trying to ship this thing first and then bring this one back. But it's just that weight, I mean, it's inevitable, you know? But, not terrible. You can't just shove it in either, though. You gotta work with it, you know? Figure it out.
Where am I supposed to go? This is not working.
I want to sit right there, but they won't let me. Why? Why can't I sit on the corner? This blows.
This sucks. This sucks. And it's, I can't even get, like, there's, it's busy. Like, this road is busy. I can't just film here.
Thank you.
like it, but it doesn't help me none.
Well, I've been in one spot for a while, which is good. Finally found somewhere I could park that nobody's gonna complain. Instead of complaining, I've had NBC 10 News come over to me and ask me some questions about the truck and try to figure out why it's here and, you know, everything about me and the truck and the story. So he said he'd come back over, he wanted to do a little interview, so we'll see what happens. I mean, if I make it on the news, it's just gonna be hilarious. I called my dad and he sent me little clips from the sky view of that chopper that's flying over, and he already spotted me a couple times, so it's pretty funny. But yeah, I don't know. Hopefully I can figure out what to say fast enough when this guy comes over, and if he does. And yeah, I might just have, you know, a little news time, so it'd be pretty cool. But yeah, see how this goes, guys. I don't know. There's just, you know, gonna be riding around again soon. We'll see how that goes and then figure it out. So see what happens.
Well, guys, that's a wrap. It's all over. I am gonna be heading home now. The B model is quite crooked on the trailer. I decided to hang out the driver's side a little bit so I could see getting it on. This has been a while since I lived by myself. I should have just drove straight. I mean, I know better. But I drove it on and I hugged the driver's side. And then by the time I looked back, I was like, man, I'm awfully crooked. But the middle axle, because the rear's walk, it's just a touch off, but it's all on the trailer. And it actually now has the stack inside the trailer rather than hanging out. So it's kind of a bittersweet deal, but I wasn't backing it back off to straighten it. It's late. Tired, it dealt with a lot. I'm ready to go. So it's on there how it's on there. Doesn't matter. So it's gonna stay. It ain't gonna go nowhere. But yeah, I'm gonna roll on out of here if this clutch brake would comply, because I know it's worn. But yeah, so we're good to rock and roll.
this, because I got a truck here, and you don't know who's doing it.
If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, brother, over and out.